Greetings and salutations, brownies. Welcome to another episode and the conclusion of Justjaz Vlogs and my series on exposing Septa. This has been an interesting journey, to say the least. When I went into this, my whole goal was to let Septa know that I was angry. Let them know that you've mistreated me and I want something for it. Damn it. But through this journey, I have learned that there is a much needed, much needed need for advocacy in the disability community. And that is what I want to do. That is kind of where I want to harness what I do on YouTube for that and other things. To kind of conclude, I want to give you guys just a few stats on my area and where I live as far as transportation and what I think can be done. Now, in my area of Septa, there are 155 train or regional rail stations. And of those 155 stations, 100 of them are wheelchair accessible, which I think is amazing considering that there are over 100 stations in New York and only 14 of them are wheelchair accessible. So we're doing good in that area. Excuse me. But with that said, how many of those stations are actually working? As I mentioned, I think in part two, when I had to go to Claymont to loop back around, that lift wasn't working. So how many of those stations work? How many of those stations does maintenance go and check? I mean, these stations and some of these accessibility implements were created and built in the 1980s, and I know they haven't. It's like, there's no way you can keep up with over 100 stations like that. So it's kind of scary to see that that's where we are. But on the good side, we are pretty progressive, and I do have to applaud Septa for trying to be as accessible as possible. Now, as a conclusion for my story, Septa has provided me with my own, I guess, personal shuttle from 30th Street Station to my house until the elevator is fixed, which is about 6 to 8 weeks that they told me. So that's really good for me. And of course, obviously, I'm happy I get my own private ride back. But it also makes me wonder how many other people in Delaware County and where I live have also had these issues and they didn't speak out. Like, who would have known? They would have maybe have had the same opportunity presented to them, but because they don't speak up, whether they're afraid or not, this is what happens. So that's what I want to do. I want to start advocating for people with disabilities and not. I just want you guys to speak up for yourselves, because no one else is going to do it. No one else is going to care. You're the one who has to do it. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this episode. This docuseries is kind of where I want to gear my channel towards. So for next series, I am going to be doing either the history of voting, not in the presidency, we're not getting into candidates, or the history of depression and my own personal stories with it. So I'm asking you guys, comment below and tell me what you want to see. Do you want to see me do voting, or do you want to see depression? Please let me know. And on that note, have a fantastic day and stay blessed. Goodbye.